The National Disaster Management Agency has been a main player in the relief efforts being given to St. Vincent and the Grenadines as they face the explosive eruptions of the last Soufriere volcano. To date, NADMA and other organizations and individuals have contributed thousands of cases of water along with food and supplies, and more is on the way. Initially, many Grenadians were concerned about last Soufriere's eruption possibly triggering Grenada's volcanoes, but it has since been revealed that there is no need to worry, as the island's volcanoes will remain unaffected. According to NADMA's Public Relations Officer, Oslyn Crosby, even though there is no need to be concerned now, the events occurring on the neighboring island can serve as a teaching point for Grenadians.
Remember, we are not immune to this. We are a volcanic island. We have Kikemgeni that is the only submarine volcano in the Eastern Caribbean, yes? But we also have Monsieur Catherine. That is another volcano. We have a number of craters all over Grenada. The lagoon, the stadium, all craters. We are volcanic in nature also. So what's happening in St. Vincent is not unique to St. Vincent. It can happen to us too, because we are also volcanic.
She said it is an opportunity for NADMA and every Grenadian to consider their level of preparedness in the event of a disaster that can happen at any time.
What I think we need to do is ensure that we are better prepared. Now that we see what's happening, let's ask ourselves the question, if this were to happen in Grenada, how will we respond as an individual, as a nation, right? As I said, the plans are there. We will now get an opportunity to go back and review and alter and adapt now to what we see happening. As an individual, let's ask ourselves the question, are we ready? If this were to happen here, what will be my next move?
Crosby said even though Grenada's volcanoes are monitored and a prior notice will be given in the event of an emergency, it is still up to individuals to be prepared.
With the monitoring system that we have in place, that we will get early notice is one thing. You can have the best of plans, but if the people who you're planning for don't respond appropriately, then your plan will fall through. And we've seen that in St. Vincent, where you have to know, instead of when the evacuation order was given, people did not move, that our first responders now have to risk their lives to go in and try to get people out of the danger zone. And you put a lot more on an already pressured system to be able to have to do rescue when you should be doing relief and other essential things as part of this disaster management process.
Anyone wishing to contribute large packages to the relief efforts for St. Vincent can contact the National Disaster Management Agency to make arrangements for drop-offs. Cholona Charles, GBN News.